We come from America to here. It's a point of grace, and we share the gospel in action.
So one of our major goals for us coming here is to try and complete a chicken coop.
And chicken is only given to them once every 3 to 4 weeks.
Lots of things have changed just based on the conditions here in Kenya, because they've had to make a lot of adjustments to account for the extra cost going into the coop.
Our chicken coop is so important to them because they're really missing that protein piece in their meals.
For supper, we were actually able to serve all of the students their supper.
It sort of felt like the feeding of the 5,000, because you look at the buckets of food and you think, wow, we have 600 kids to feed. How is this going to stretch?
It really affects the lives of these people and the extended families. Many of them are orphans, so they only have too much family.
It was very overwhelming. There was so many more hands and so much more need.
We're going to be going into the villages, going into the homes, going into the huts, and we'll find ourselves in different situations, some of them unexpected.
Well, there's a ladies' organization that Lorna has started. Not every woman in this organization is a Christian. Several of them are not, so this is a great witnessing opportunity to share the love of Christ.
And that's just neat to see in any language or wherever you're at. You know, we're all here for the same purpose, and that's for God.
Just so powerful to know that on this side of the world that we're worshiping, the same God who's taking care of everyone back at home, and just that we are one big family of Christ.
You have to be here to see the extent of it, but just take it from me and the team, it's just awesome.